Hello and welcome to Market Ki Baatein. My name is Raja Venkatraman. I'm the co-founder of NeoTrader and also your trading influencer. Been in the markets for more than 15 years, happily married with a loving wife and an energetic son who keeps me on the run just like the markets. So friends, welcome back once again to Market Ki Baatein, and I'm sure that every episode you're getting to learn something new, and I'm sure that you are definitely having a very good idea about how to participate in the markets and how to ensure that you are able to get the best out of the market participation. So, well, we are going to get once again into more details about what we are doing, how we have to participate, and how we have to get a picture of what the markets are in action, when the markets are in action. So today's topic is how are we going to take a trade using the concept of candlestick pattern. And today's candlestick pattern, which I have chosen, is the hammer pattern. Yes, hammer pattern is something which is quite familiar to many of you. But then when you come down to participate in the markets with the hammer pattern, it always becomes a challenge, right? So let me just share my screen and share with you guys as to, first of all, let's try and identify how does a hammer pattern look like, and what goes on in a hammer pattern, where do we have to look at it, and all those elements. Let's go and take a look at it now, right? So when you take a look at the charts, all right, so you're going to take a look at the charts, the exact hammer pattern you always find when you are at the end of a decline, right? Whenever the prices are coming down, that is when you need to find out if the candlestick setup is showing you a hammer pattern. So how does a hammer pattern look like? A hammer pattern looks something like this. It is a small body pattern. It's a small body which is having a tall shadow. So you see a hammer pattern at the end of a fall. So you have a decline like this, and you see a hammer pattern which indicates. What does a hammer pattern indicate? Let's try and find it out, right? Hammer pattern indicates, so this part, this part is called as the shadow, and this part is called as the body, right? So you have the shadow and you have the body. So when the body is small and you have a tall shadow, right, then you have a small body and a tall shadow on the downside. This indicates that there is a demand. Okay, and this demand is actually pushing the closing to the upside. So how is a body formed? Body of a candlestick, it is connecting the open and the close, right? You connect the open and the close, you get a body. So now when the body is small and you have a long shadow beneath the body, it indicates that there has been some buying emerging here, which is pushing the prices up. So all these things indicates that there could be a potential reversal. Okay, there could be a potential reversal with the upside. All these things indicate that there could be a potential reversal to the upside. So the first thing is check for a fall in price. Second is wait for the prices to halt. And the third is a follow through of the hammer pattern formation, right? So I believe that you have got an idea now of how a particular pattern has to be identified, right? You got an idea of how a particular hammer pattern has to be identified, and how you will be able to get a insight into how the action can be taken for the price action, right? So now let's go down into the charts and find out how can we action this particular hammer pattern and ensure that we are able to get some insight on what really is happening. So first, let's take a look at the Bank Nifty charts, right? All of you can take a look at the Bank Nifty charts here. And you can see here that Bank Nifty over the last few weeks, okay, it has been steadily making a higher high, higher low, right? So you can see here a continuous move. There is a continuous move to the upside, correct? So now if you see here, there is a steady move and then price dipping and then again rising. So there is a steady movement of prices. It is forming a higher low. You can see here, this is your first low. This is your second low. This is your third low. So there is a steady move in the prices and prices are steadily moving to the upside. So now this is an indication that the prices are on the buy side. So now let's go and take a look at the lower time frame charts and find out whether we can spot any hammer patterns out there. So let's go into a 30-minute chart. At the end of the video, I'm also going to be showing you a potential hammer pattern that has developed and which can really give us a very strong move. All right. So let's first take a look at the hammer pattern here. So you can see here that over the last few days, the prices have actually come down in Bank Nifty, right? Bank Nifty, the prices came down quite steadily. It went down all the way from here, from almost around, came from 36,000 all the way steadily, lower low, lower high. And finally, okay, finally at this juncture, can you see here? Right at this place, let me just mark it out. Just clear the zone here. So if you see here, there is one hammer pattern which has got formed. And out here, there is another hammer pattern that has got formed. So what you are observing here right now is two hammer formation that have actually created a low in Bank Nifty. You can see here, there are two hammer patterns that have been formed and that have created a low in Bank Nifty. So now, with that being the case, you saw a move from 34,000 all the way till 35,000. You can see here a nice strong move to the upside, which indicated that there was a low being formed and the whole price moved up. So now the question is, how can we action this particular move? So let's get down to the action, right? And let's go and take a look at how can we action the same. So whenever you see a hammer formation, the first thing you got to do is you got to wait. I'm going to wait for the confirmation. So what are the first thing which happened on the first hammer? All you have to do is use the concept of trend line. You can see here, there was a nice trend line formation here. And once this trend line formation was crossed, you had a nice opportunity here, but then this was somewhere towards the end of the day. So as an intraday possibility, there was not much room here. So on the next day, again, you had a hammer formation out here. Once the hammer formation was there, you can see that the prices managed to make a low, and then subsequently, once it crossed the trend line, you can see here, there was a very strong possibility of an upside. The upside continued because the movement came earlier in the day. And after that, the prices have moved up, with the gap and gave us a lot of potential to move to the upside. So this is one example where you can see that the hammer formation even works in the lower time frame. So now let me show you a chart where the hammer formation has worked quite well. All right. So let me just pull up this chart here. You can see this chart here right now. And you can see here that the movement which is unfolding here. You can see here this is a chart of Bajaj Finance. And you can see here that the prices are unfolding and prices are moving steadily to the downside. So you can see here that prices have actually gone all the way from 5800 and steadily making a lower low, lower high all the way to 4400. Right now at 4400, you saw that there was something called as a hammer being formed here, right? So there was a downside gap. There was expectation. Okay? There was expectation that the prices would go lower, but it did not move down. And you had the formation of a hammer. And once the hammer was formed, there was a downside gap. Okay. We'll talk about gaps a little later in some other video, but here you can see that there was a downside gap. And once this downside gap emerged, everyone thought that prices would travel lower, but instead there was a hammer formed and then it was followed up with an upside gap, right? There was an upside gap here, and then there are other candlestick patterns, which we will discuss in the other session. So today we are concentrating on the hammer. So you can see here, once this pattern was formed, you can see that there was an upside gap and the prices managed to move very, very swiftly. So when you see this hammer, you got to get ready for a reversal. And if you had just used the concept of trend line, you can see that, yes, you were entering the trade late, but then you always had a confirmation. So once this confirmation is there and the prices go beyond the trend line, it is a very, very strong signal that the prices are now going to go up. And you can see here that a strong move to the upside is very much on the cards. And you can see here that the steady move to the upside moved from 4750 all the way up till 5750. So you can see the strong potential move that came about. And this was a very, very superb move, which we saw in Bajaj Finance. And in a span of less than a month and a half, you saw a 1,000-point move in Bajaj Finance. I'll show you now one more example where this particular pattern is emerging and it is about to give you a very strong move. So you can see here this chart of Havells a few days ago. You can see here how this particular move is unfolding. You can see that the prices are unable to cross this important level here. Right? You can see here this important level. So this is a nice resistance zone where it has been trying, but it has been unable to go beyond it, and the resultant fall, right? You can see here, sharp fall over the last few sessions. It has been moving this resistance zone around 1100. It has not been able to cross, and it steadily came down. And now what has happened is just two sessions ago, it has formed a hammer pattern here, right? It has formed a hammer pattern. It's a very powerful mover. It has formed a hammer pattern here. And now it has opened today slightly higher and it is showing indication of moving up. So now if you want to action this for the immediate term, you can see here that all you have to do is draw a simple trend line. Tomorrow, if you have a move above 1015, you have a very, very strong potential candidate to go up as far as Havells is concerned. And this way, you will be able to get a very good entry into Havells. So this is how you got to work the hammer pattern. So let me just show you once again. Wait for the decline. And then once the hammer pattern is formed, all you have to do is wait for the follow through. First, identify the fall, then wait for the hammer pattern to form. Once the hammer pattern is formed, then wait for the follow through. For the follow through, use the concept of trend line, just like I've shown you. You can go back and review this video again, and you will get to know how you can act based on the simple concept called as hammer pattern. I hope all of you got some insight on how to trade the hammer pattern. If you like what you saw, if you like what you observed, and if you feel that this video has added some value to how you are going to trade the markets, please leave a like. If you are watching this video for the first time on our channel, do subscribe to our channel, because we're going to be coming up with more such interesting videos to enhance your trading and to enhance your perspective. And you can also comment on this video as to how you have been using the hammer pattern and how you have made some successful trades using this hammer pattern. Thank you for watching this Market Ki Baatein episode. I'll connect with you once again in another one. Thank you so much. Have a good day. Stay safe. Stay healthy. This is Raja Venkatraman signing off.